It's not your imagination. No, you're not black American. You wonder why they call you Jamaican. When you above all the other nations. It's not your imagination. No, you're not a Haitian. You wonder why they call you Puerto Rican. When you above all the other nations. It's not your imagination. They just wanna keep us down.
Welcome back to Four Corners News.
That's right, where the truth speaks. I'm Captain Zakar. To my left,
Captain Severus.
To his left,
Officer Azaniah.
To our far left,
Officer Judah.
And to my right,
Officer Daniel.
And to my far right,
Officer Lyle.
And we make up Four Corners News. That's right. Thank you for staying tuned tonight. Let's get into tonight's main topic. Bring it up. Let's read that for him, Officer.
Here we go.
Yahoo News. Children in West Africa.
West Africa, ding, 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 ding. You Negroes, you Jamaicans, you Haitians.
Right.
West Africa, and you Puerto Ricans, too.
That's right.
You came from there, too. Don't get it tripping. You one of us.
Ephraim.
You Negro, too. Go back to it.
Me no blah.
Yeah. Read that.
Children in West Africa are working in dangerous conditions to fuel a $100 billion chocolate industry that has failed to crack down on child labor.
$100 billion chocolate.
With a B.
Child labor. $100 billion. It said they failed to crack down. No, it didn't fail. They didn't want to crack down.
It's too big to fail.
Right. You think they're gonna this is the mind of the Negro, man. You really think that they are gonna stop a $100 billion industry
where
kids are the main workforce for it?
Right.
How are they gonna recoup $100 billion if it ain't the children doing it?
Right.
Where you gonna get that money from?
Cause you gotta understand, once you tap into that realm of a billion, remember they want to maintain that. Mm. What can we do more
to increase it?
So this is just another name. It's just another form of slavery. That's just because every time that you see Esau society going up or the so-called white man society going up, there has to be a black man at the bottom building it up.
Oh, that's right.
Hey, and that stems all the way back from the time of the Greeks.
Yeah.
Can I get that real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
First Maccabees. Give me that First Maccabees chapter 3 and verse 41.
Three, dude.
First Maccabees chapter 3 and verse 31.
41.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. And the merchants of the country.
The merchants, the $100 billion conglomerate companies,
read. Hearing the fame of them.
Uh-huh, the fame of the Israelites, read.
Took silver and gold.
It took a lot of money, read.
Very much. With servants and came into the camp to buy the children of Israel for slaves.
So there's nothing new under the sun. We've been going through this since from the ancient time of the Greeks that they've been seeking our children for slaves to build up their economy.
That's bondage, man. And the worst part about it is we can't do nothing as a people.
Right.
Go back to the article and let's read it, man. Let's read that article. Let's just read the bullet points. Read that.
First bullet point, a new report commissioned by the U.S. Department of Labor has revealed the staggering level of dangerous child labor in the $100 billion chocolate industry.
Uh-huh. Go ahead.
The report from University of Chicago researchers found that 1.56 million children in Ghana.
In where?
In Ghana.
Uh-huh.
In the Ivory Coast. We're working in the industry.
Now, Negroes know damn well we came from Ghana and the Ivory Coast.
Right. That's right.
We came from the west coast of Africa. That's common knowledge. We all know that. So if they you know what that proves right there? Because what them Negroes right now about to do? When the November the 3rd or something?
Bring it out.
When they vote? When do people vote?
November 3rd,
right? Mm-hmm. 3rd. Or the 6th. It's one of the two. It's because they've got freedom to vote for who they want to. That right there proves that we are yet this day still in our captivity. Give it to me. Baruch chapter 3, verse 8. This is what Negroes do. We turn a blind eye to our brother or our sister that are suffering just like us. Just because the plantation owner gave us a little bit more of freedoms than he did our other brothers. Right. But we still in captivity. Here's the proof. Read it.
Baruch chapter 3 and verse 8.
Uh-huh. Bring it out.
Behold, we are yet this day in our captivity.
Yet this day. You know what? When Bishop and them, I bet if they read this over there, they probably have, you know, because the videos, it ain't all of what they do when they go over to Ghana and Sierra Leone.
Right.
When they read this scripture on the west coast of Africa, in Ghana and Sierra Leone, they read that right there, that thing hit like a damn Mike Tyson right hook.
Yeah, yes, it do.
I wouldn't be surprised they lock us up for doing that, too.
Yeah, read that over
bring
there.
Bring that out? Oh, man.
You know Captain Gag will be happy that I referenced Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson is not the best boxer. He would never beat Muhammad Ali. I want you to understand that.
Moving on.
Come on. Are you
moving on.
Moving on.
Hey. Go back to that, man. Go back to that. And it says most of them.
Most of them are. Most of them were working in hazardous conditions, defined by working in the night, clearing land, carrying heavy loads, and using sharp tools, the report found. In 2010, major chocolate companies vowed to cut.
Now listen to this. It said 2010. That means what's 10 years? That's a decade, right?
Yeah, right. Yep.
A decade ago, they did what? Go back to it.
In 2010, major chocolate companies vowed to cut 70% of the worst forms of child labor by 2020.
Now check this out. Look at this. This is how wicked their oppressor is. They did not say we're going to cut child labor altogether, completely gone 100%, because this is wrong that they are carrying around sharp tools and jagged edges and heavy loads and all of this stuff.
They should be allowed to be children.
We are going to 70%. How about 70? Not 100. We ain't going to give you 100%.
Right.
Because that will break our bank.
That's why the Bible
70%.
That's why the devil the Bible speaks of.
Right.
Because what they really trying to say is, y'all got caught.
Yeah.
Right. Y'all got caught. So yes.
I'm sorry. I got
our
caught.
Money got to go with us. Some of our money.
Yeah.
So get your act together. Make sure you clean it up before we can go all in. But right now, you got caught. You messed up.
That's crazy.
They allowed to do things like that, how you were saying before about, because us over here, a lot of our brothers and sisters, they trapped in a bubble.
Yeah, yeah.
They trapped in a bubble.
That's why we got to bring it out on Four Corners News.
Right. Yeah. Hey, Cap, I can get a screen.
Bring it.
Go to Nehemiah chapter 9. In reverse 36.
That's the one.
Because that's what our people suffer, being trapped in this bubble called the U.S. of A, and have not figured out that we are still in captivity.
That's right.
They haven't figured it out. Read that.
Nehemiah chapter 9 and verse 16.
Come on.
But they and our fathers dealt proudly.
Nehemiah
chapter 9 verse 16.
Bring it out.
Verse 36. Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 36.
Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 36.
Uh-huh.
Behold, we are servants this day, and for the land that thou gavest unto our fathers.
Because they might say that they're breaking child labor laws, but really that's slavery.
Yeah.
Period.
Right.
Thou gavest unto our fathers to eat the fruit thereof and the good thereof.
Come on.
Behold, we are servants in it.
Come on.
And it yieldeth much increase unto the kings whom thou hast set over us because of our sins.
That's what Officer Judah was bringing out. That those fields that they own, it bring forth much increase. That's but what you said, it was $100 billion.
$100 billion.
Damn. Come on.
Also, they have dominion over our bodies.
There you go.
Over our what?
Over our bodies.
Read.
And over our cattle at their pleasure.
At their pleasure.
They could take your kids if they want to.
Exactly.
At their pleasure.
That's that. I can't give them all percent. I'll just do 70%.
70%. That's it.
Cap, you know what that reminds me of? Remember about Benin, the history that Bishop went over?
Yeah, yeah.
About them just pretty much cutting off their arms?
Yeah. No, that's Democratic Congo.
Congo.
That's the Democratic Congo where they
Leopold.
Were cut off.
Leopold.
King Leopold of Belgium.
Belgium
would cut off the right hands of our people over there if they didn't bring them back. Chocolate, rubber, whatever it might be.
Right,
and they made a damn candy off of it in Belgium.
Belgium chocolates.
Belgium chocolate hands to symbolize him cutting off millions of hands, man.
That's mockery.
Pretty much, they never stop. You mind if I just pull one scripture?
Yeah, yeah, go ahead, man.
Go to Ezekiel chapter 35 and let's read verse 5.
Bring it out.
So this is what we're seeing. He never changed his ways. His soul is not upright in him, so therefore his ways cannot change. Right. Read that.
Ezekiel chapter 35 and verse 5.
Bring it out.
Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred.
And we're seeing that perpetual hatred where they started way back when, even going into the Congos, and even now we're reading about $70 billion. Is it $100 billion?
$100 billion
of their society.
Don't cheat them. It's $100 billion.
Right. They still profiting off our people. Read.
And has shed the blood of the children of Israel.
Mm. So what do you think happens when they're using the child laborers? Their bodies is so fragile and they could only do so much.
Yeah, yeah.
There's nobody that's really out there that's telling them, hey, listen, child regulation laws or anything like that. They don't
bring
have
it out.
So kids just be just dropping dead. They be like, okay, move on.
Right, those accidents on the job, because those kids not on the file. Right.
Let's go back to that article real quick.
Man.
Go back to that. So they didn't cut it at all. Read the next bullet point. I think it's, read that one.
Kareem Kasiya, one of the authors of the report, told Business Insider that support from big brands and industry organization needs to be scaled up.
So it need to be checks and balances on companies like Reese's, name some of Snickers, Hershey's. Mars Candies.
Come on, you know they in there. You know.
And I know you know our people, and I know you watching on Facebook, YouTube. You know you be loving some candy. We got a lot of brothers and sisters that got what they call it in our society, sweet tooth. Right. A lot of us got sweet tooth, so we are indulging ourselves and enjoying the chocolates off the backs of the oppression of our own brothers that are still on the west coast of Africa.
And Cap, also there's a so-called holiday coming up right now.
Bring it out.
What's about that?
Halloween. And that's when the most chocolate gets bought. What was the other one?
Valentine's Day.
So look at this. Check this out. We are furthering the oppression of our own brothers on the West Coast that are still there to celebrate and worship the devil in Halloween.
Yeah. Right.
And to further push fornication, adultery.
Right. That's right.
Damn.
Halloween and what you call it? What's the other one?
Valentine's Day.
Fornication, whoredom, and worshiping of the devil. Yeah. We put our brothers in more hard bondage, man. We gotta check our spirit over here, man. Yeah.
That's the only time we come together in wickedness.
That's why the scripture says, "Come out of her, my people."
That's right.
Yeah.
Because the Lord wants us to get out of the way, because He want to pass judgment. He's itching for it.
Yeah.
Right.
Go to Revelation 18.
Read
it. Revelation 18.
Was it 18:4?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Revelation chapter 18 and verse 4.
Bring it out.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, "Come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins."
Not partakers. The only way you're going to be not a partaker, meaning you got to come up out of Halloween.
Bring it out.
Yeah, yeah.
Valentine's Day.
Yep.
As soon as we begin to do that and we gather ourselves in righteousness under the banner of Christ and the commandments, the Lord could throw a mighty rock.
That's right.
In the name of, what's the name of the missile that Russia got?
Satan.
Satan 2. That's the rock the Lord wants to throw at Babylon the Great.
That's
the
ball.
It's going to take for you to come out of her.
Hey, that's a good. I'm glad you went here, because check this. This proves that our brothers and sisters suffering from the chocolate slavery industry, because it ain't no damn child labor. Mm-hmm. It is child slavery that is still going on over there. Revelation 18 proves that Babylon the Great is America. Jump up to verse 11, and I want you to read down the 13. Read that.
Revelation chapter 18 and verse 11.
Bring it out.
And the merchants
and
of the
what?
the merchants of the earth.
The corporations, the chocolate corporations. Wow. Hershey, the Mars, the damn, what's some other
Snickers.
Ones? Snickers.
Kit Kat bars,
whatever you want to call them.
Nestle's.
Three Musketeers.
These are the corporations, the merchants of the earth. Read on.
Shall weep and mourn over her, for no man buyeth their merchandise anymore.
Ain't going to be no more $100 billion chocolate child slavery.
Bring it out.
No more when God throws that rock called Satan 2 at Babylon the Great.
Right.
Ain't going to be no more sending our kids to the damn salt mines.
Right.
Bring it out.
Not only with chocolate, also with diamonds over there in Sierra Leone, Ghana, West Africa, and all of that, man. Read on, verse 12.
The merchandise of gold and silver. And precious stones.
What is that? It's talking about the diamonds. That's talking about the diamonds over there in West Coast of Africa. Read.
And of pearls and fine linen and purple and silk and scarlet and of fine wood and all manner vessels of ivory.
Of ivory. What do they call that over there on the West Coast of Africa? They call it the Ivory Coast. Right. Verse 12 is talking about West Coast of Africa, where the Israelites are.
Bring it out.
It's talking, all of this stuff we're reading in verse 12 can be found in Africa.
That's right.
Specifically on that West Coast of Africa, too.
And also,
we in slavery at.
Also, Liberia, Sierra Leone.
All of it.
Is called the Gold Coast.
The Gold Coast.
Bring it out.
That's where they got us from. It's going to prove it, too. Read on in that.
In all manner, vessels of most precious wood. And of brass and iron and marble and cinnamon and odors and ointments and frankincense and wine and oil and fine flour and wheat and beast and sheep and horses and chariots.
And what else?
And slaves.
And slaves.
Both sides are genius.
That's what we read it about the $100 billion check, the $100 billion chocolate industry is built off the slaves of the Israelites on the West Coast of Africa.
Right.
Slaves and what else?
And souls of men.
And souls of men. And just in case you don't believe that this is talking about right there on the West Coast of Africa, that they enslaved us and found all of these things over here. They brought us here to Babylon the Great, and the Lord's going to throw that damn rock called Satan 2. Pull up that next picture to show the transatlantic slave trade, to show where they got us from.
Right.
Pull it up, because the article said Ghana and Sierra Leone. Right. Zoom in on it.
Here we go.
Zoom in on that thing. Look at that. Right there on that West Coast of Africa, Sierra Leone.
Damn.
The Windsor Coast, the Gold Coast, that's also known as the Ivory Coast in that area, too.
Damn. Number of captives.
And that's talking about, what is that, the Bight of Benin, the Bight of Biafra, West Central Africa.
Damn.
And you look, they shipped us.
Hey, look at those numbers, Cap.
Hundreds
of thousands.
Wow.
What the hell is a Jewish Holocaust compared to these numbers that we're
bring it out?
That's right.
What is that?
Bring it out. Go back to it, man, and look where they sent us. They sent us to Dutch Guyana. Yep. They sent us to Tobago, Trinidad. Scroll up some so we can see the top. Sent us to Jamaica, Dominguez, Bahamas. Florida, Mississippi Delta, Georgia, Carolinas, Virginia, Maryland, New York. So, and look, you see, they
South
took us up right to Spain, too.
Spain.
Yep. South America as well.
South America as well. So what we read it about that West Coast Africa, $100 billion chocolate slavery, that is being built off of our back, off the real Jews
that
are still in the West Coast of Africa. It's on their children.
Yeah. To this day.
Just to land back off you, jump down to verse 24. Let's see what God calls the slaves and the souls of men. Let's see what God calls them. Read.
Revelation chapter 18 and verse 24.
Bring it out.
And in her was found the blood of prophets.
Mm. Who are the slaves? The slaves are the prophets. That's right. Read.
And of saints.
Read.
And of all that were slain upon the earth.
So guess what? You're going to have to pay for the blood that you shed of the prophets and of the saints, which are the Israelites.
That you brought to Babylon the Great.
Bring it out.
Hey, Cap.
Also, to land back off of what you just said, what were those prophets that were being slain? What were they teaching the people to do? Can we get Baruch chapter 2?
Bring it out.
Get Baruch chapter 2, verse 6. You want to see that rock take out America? This is what the prophets were teaching the people to do in order for them to see the kingdom of heaven on earth. The kingdom of God where the Israelites, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans ruled.
That's
check
right.
this out. Baruch chapter 2, start from verse 6.
Make it quick.
Baruch chapter 2 and verse 6.
Just
read
it out.
Read verse 8 and then read verse 30.
Verse 8 and verse 30. Yet have we not prayed before the Lord.
Uh-huh.
That we might turn everyone from the imaginations of his wicked heart.
So that we would turn away from all the sins, the Halloweens, the Christmas, the birthdays, all of these things. We would turn away from these things and keep God's commandments. Read verse 30.
Verse 30.
Uh-huh.
For I knew that they would not hear me because uh-huh. it is a stiff-necked people.
Read.
But in the land of their captivity.
Here in America, here in the place where we were brought as captives. Read.
They shall remember themselves.
They're going to remember that they are the Israelites. To
that's
keep
right.
God's commandments.
Right.
So
right.
Bring it out. Rock, take out Babylon.
That's hey, right. Hey, go ahead. Hey, go to the video real quick because we got some videos I want to pull for that, man. Pull up that video real quick. Pull up that video and let's play that. Guilty pleasure.
There's almost nothing that children love more than chocolate. But there are some kids who are forced to make it.
Look at that. That's our people. That's our people.
CNN won't play this.
Nah, not at all.
70% comes from just two countries, Ghana and the Ivory Coast, west coast of Africa. Yep. 70%. More than 2 million children are used to harvest that very cocoa.
We'll see
thousands of them work on plantations.
Oh,
that's
crazy. Oh, wow. The saddest part of this report is that, well, this isn't news. 18 years ago, the largest consumer of chocolate, the U.S., introduced a bill that promised
this place
to
got
prohibit
to go.
And eradicate the worst forms of child labor in the industry. All eight major chocolate companies
look
signed
at that.
Up.
M&M, Nestle.
2001.
Yes, yeah.
But by 2005, the chocolate industry failed to fulfill its promise.
With Damn. Only a few months remaining, it has become apparent that the chocolate industry is nowhere near meeting its obligations.
Pause.
To ins-
that means they don't want to stop
yes,
it.
Right. That's right. It right there.
They don't want to stop it. That's they can it. Easily close down all the damn factories, right. pack right. up. But you know how you know they can do that? Because as soon as a damn Democratic president gets elected
Bring
in America, the company shut down in a year yeah. and they gone to damn India.
Yeah, right. Right.
So you mean to tell me in 20 years, they can't shut down a child slave chocolate factory
right.
and get up out of there if they wanted to truly change? They could. They could do it in a month, but they don't want to do it.
No.
That's the thing.
$100 billion says no.
Damn devils, man. Go to the Woo. Next video. Go to the next video real quick, man.
And this is just candy, y'all.
That's candies. It ain't talk about chocolate. The diamonds, the gold.
Come on.
Right.
Go
right.
to the next video real quick.
More than 152 million children in the world are living in forced labor, slavery, or prostitution. That's more than twice the number of children in all of the United States.
Damn.
The majority of these kids work in dangerous environments that are likely to result in physical or mental injuries and permanent harm. Nearly half of these children are just 5 to 11 years old.
5 to 11.
For many of us, these tiny Ooh. Unseen hands mine cobalt for the batteries in our phones.
Pause it! Cobalt for your batteries, if you don't know that comes from the west coast of yep. Africa. Now, I know we got, you know, damn, it is yeah, what it is. We, right, we got to serve the white man. Yeah. We know what it is. But we just making you known of where this stuff come from, that we are yet this day in our captivity.
Bring it out. Right.
We can't be blind to that as a people. We got to wake up and connect the dots and realize we are the Israelites.
That's right.
Go back to
right.
the video.
Right.
Go back to the video. Play it.
Sew our designer clothes and harvest and package the bananas we eat for breakfast. So why does child labor persist, and how can we stop it? Child labor is defined as work that is harmful to children or interferes with their education.
Stop it. It said, how can we stop it? There's no way you can stop the curses of God.
Right. That's right.
Bring
There's
it
no
out.
Way. The only way it will be stopped is when Jesus the Christ returns and redeems us.
That's it.
Right. That's the only way that it will stop. that our children will be set free and they can play and walk around with the lions on a leash and right. play on the holes of a cobra. Yep. That's it. It's only when Christ set up the kingdom. I think it's one more video, the next one about the chocolate factories. Pull up about the 6 chocolate factories, man. The biggest major ones here in Babylon the Great. Pull it up. Play that. This is real. This is happening right now. That ain't like that article was 10 years ago. That was published this month.
Damn.
2016, a lawsuit claimed that major chocolate companies relied on child slave labor. Most cocoa in the main ingredient chocolate is grown in West Africa. That's our people. The Ivory Coast and Ghana. 60%. They don't know right from wrong, and Esau is exploiting them.
Right. And even harder.
Look at that. Pause it. They are isolated and forced to work up to 100 hours a week.
Wow.
Man. Amazing. Wow.
100 hours a week, y'all.
Curses 40 kill me.
We can't work 40 here right. in Babylon.
Damn. We're stressing over 40. Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy.
Extra overtime.
Give me that in Ezekiel 28 real quick, man. We about to close it out, man. But give me that Ezekiel 28, and I wanna show. This is how we read about that that gold and that cinnamon and that brass and all of that. This is how it was able to happen. Ezekiel 28, and let's read verse 3.
Ezekiel right. chapter 28, verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Behold. Thou art wiser than Daniel.
Now this is talking. It says Tyrus in this verse, but that's a code for Esau because if you read verse 2, it says I sit in the seat of God. The only people that say that on the earth is Esau, but God's using Tyrus because they was a major trading industry back in the ancient biblical days. Major, they was, you know, the another word, they was like global traders.
Right.
Tyrus was a global trader. They traveled everywhere and traded. Right. From Rome, all of them places, back down to where we was on the west coast of Israel, right? Read on, verse 3 again.
Behold, thou art wiser than Daniel.
Uh-huh.
There is no secret that they can hide from thee.
That's through technology. Read on.
Which thy wisdom and with thine understanding.
With thy wisdom of the stock market, of business, of how to trade in slaves. Read.
Thou hast gotten thee riches.
They did what?
Gotten thee riches.
They gotten thee riches by enslaving our young children. Promising to, we'll do away with it in 10 years. 10 years later, nothing done. Guess what's going to happen in another? That report was published, and guess what will happen in another 10 years? Not a damn thing.
Right.
Only 100 billion more.
That's right. It. Yeah. It'd probably be 200 billion.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
It'd
right.
probably be 200 hours a week.
Yeah.
Read on in that.
And has gotten gold and silver into thy treasury.
Read on.
By thy great wisdom and by thy traffic.
By thy what?
By thy traffic.
Traffic is called trading. That's global trading from one continent to another. Read on.
Has thou increased thy riches,
uh-huh.
and thine heart is lifted up because of thy riches.
Thy pride, read on.
Therefore thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast set thine heart as the heart of God,
uh-huh.
behold, therefore I will bring strangers upon thee, the terrible of the nations.
The terrible of the nations, that's called what? Terrorist. Read on.
And they shall draw their swords against the beauty of thy wisdom,
uh-huh.
and they shall defile thy brightness.
They will destroy America from the inside out, thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
Why? Right. Because they have traded in slaves and the souls of man. Mm. Child slavery in the chocolate industry, making $100 billion off the backs of Jews.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.